LeBron in a second, but first, couple of big plays from last night. Bucks, Grizzlies, Jamaal Green drives and dunks on Ersan Ilyasova.
I mean, do I even need to say it?
Well, no, you have to get beyond the circle to take a charge. I mean, you can't expect to get a charge and you're in the restricted area.
Ersan, guess what? You got what you deserved. Jamaal Green, go do it to him.
See, this is the thing you don't understand, Nick. There's nothing wrong with getting dunked on. I saw KD get dunked on last night. It's part of being in the NBA.
I got no problem with guys getting dunked on in go contest.
Giannis backs down Justin Holiday. Dunks all over Marc Gasol.
Marc Gasol, that's him trying to contest, man. He can't jump over, I would say, a phone book, but I don't think those exist anymore. Can't jump over, I don't know, an encyclopedia. Those don't exist anymore either. I'm an old man all of a sudden. Look at Jamichael. But look at Giannis, pardon me.
Rockets, Nets, Jared Allen. He's blocked LeBron, Giannis, Blake, and Anthony Davis already. Now he adds James Harden to the list.
Now, you don't have a chance to take a charge this time because you're at the three-point line.
Right.
Nick. So you have to try to
go
get it.
You got to contest.
Now, he's one of the best at this in the league. Now, I think he should have put it off high off the backboard.
Finally, same game, James Harden puts the defender on skates. His 50 of 58 points.
We're going to obviously spend some time on Harden today. We're running out of words for what he's doing. The Rockets blew this game twice.
Yeah, they didn't win.
8-point lead with 90 seconds left, goes to overtime. 7-point lead with 90 seconds left in overtime, loss.
Yep, friend of the show, Spencer Dinwiddie, did him in.
Yeah, he did.
Brooklyn's playing some good basketball.
Beat Boston, beat Houston. Really good.
Oh, Brooklyn in the playoff, Lakers out the playoff.
Oh, that's
moving
a hot take.
To the Celtics. Kyrie Irving did good things on the basketball court last night. His passes were good, his shots went in, and his team won. 27 points and a career-high 18 assists in a win over the Toronto Raptors. Celtics have been in a bit of a turmoil lately after Kyrie called out the team's young players. Not easy being a leader of men. Kyrie learned this the hard way and turned to an unlikely source for advice.
It was a big deal for me because I had to call Bron, you know, and tell him, like, you know, I apologize for being that young player that wanted to everything at his, you know, at his fingertips, and I wanted everything to be at, you know, my threshold. I wanted to be the guy that led us to championship. I wanted to be the leader. I wanted to be all that, and, you know, the responsibility of being the best player in the world and leading a team is something that's not meant for many people. And Bron was one of those guys that came to Cleveland and tried to really show us what it's like to win a championship, and it was hard for him. And sometimes getting the most out of the group, it's not the easiest thing in the world. And like I said, only few are meant for it or chosen for it. And, you know, I feel like the best person to call was him because, you know, he's been in the situation. You know, he's been there with me where I've been the young guy of, you know, being a 22-year-old kid and, you know, wanting everything. Wanting everything right now. You know, coming off an all-star year starting and then, you know, this heck of a presence comes back. And now I got to adjust my game to this guy. And, you know, you take it personal, but at the end of the day, he just wants what's best. And he has a legacy he wants to leave, and he has a window he wants to capture. So I think what that brought me back to is, like, all right, how do I get the best out of this group of the success they had last year? And then helping them realize what it takes to win a championship.
So a lot there out of Kyrie. What did you make of what he had to say, Nick?
Good for Kyrie Irving, man. This is like the next step in his evolution as a player, evolution as a leader. Forget what he did on the court, which was one of the best regular season games of his career. Like, who they were playing, the fact that his team was in a slump, there was turmoil, and he had a career-high 18 assists. But that takes us backseat to what happened after the game, which is him recognizing being a great player is only part of the equation of being the leader on a championship team. And recognizing that what I thought I knew, I didn't actually know. What I thought was wrong actually might have been right. I just wasn't ready to accept it. And so I didn't see these comments until this morning. I saw the game last night, but I didn't see these guys. I woke up to these comments, and they were actually sent to me, they texted to me. And I saw it, and I was like, wow. Like, that is evolution from a player who we all know how talented he is. And it struck me by total surprise, and I give him enormous credit for taking that step and not only reaching out to LeBron, but then telling the world about it, which he did not have to do.
Yeah, you got to give Kyrie Irving credit for one, for reaching out to LeBron. Number two, being able to share that information. But the truth of the matter is, he's still not out of the woods, because to me, he's still very, very naive about what it takes to be a great leader. And at what point, besides high school, has he been a great leader?
Right.
All right? Played a partial season there at Duke. He was basically 1 foot in college basketball, 1 foot in the NBA already. He went to Cleveland. They were horrible. He was not a leader there. Just because you're the best player, just because you're the most talented, that does not make you a leader. And even him right now, the stage he's at, yeah, he did a great job apologizing. But that doesn't mean he's the leader of the Celtics. Like, that doesn't mean just because he apologized, like, he still got a lot to be able to learn. Last night, it was a tremendous game because he was able to score and distribute the basketball. But I still believe that there's going to be problems there in Boston. Last year, a lot of people had Brad Stevens as the second best coach in the NBA. And I said, okay. All right, I don't believe you because I haven't seen enough, and I want to see him when he has a talented NBA team, not a team like Butler, because that's what the Celtics have been, and that's when he's gotten his best work out of teams that didn't have the big stars and role players. So for me, I still believe Kyrie Irving has a lot to learn as far as being a leader, because being a leader has a lot to do with, are you going to be the first guy there? Are you going to be the last guy to leave? Are you going to take care of your body and eat the way that you're trying to tell everyone to be able to maximize their performance? Because all those things play a role in being a leader in an NBA locker room.
Listen, I fully agree with you on as far as the Celtics and Kyrie not being out of the woods. I have been skeptical of this team within the Eastern Conference all year long, and one great win over Toronto after three bad losses doesn't solve that. But this is, to me, a first and necessary step. Now, I do know, like I said before the show, I said, you probably shouldn't have to give birth to know what's painful. You shouldn't necessarily have to live an experience to be able to relate to it. But you said, you don't know what you don't know. And like Kyrie is now, and I know that's an old, it's a tautology, it's an old axiom, but it's true. Like sometimes you think things shouldn't be this way, and then you live them yourselves and you realize they are. The Celtics do have a lot of work to do, but Kyrie's got to be the leader of that team because Tatum and Brown aren't ready. I don't think Horford is.
That's the problem. When you get into this appointment based on salary, you get in this appointment based on skill compared to who really are the leaders. A lot of times people, they don't want to give LeBron, but LeBron recruited guys that were their own leaders in their own way. Ray Allen was a leader. Cal Corbett, they were leaders in everything. So you have to know how to bring leadership out in other people. You have to know how to empower other people. So there's a lot that I need to be able to see.
But let me ask you, because in your experience with team sports, isn't the ideal situation that your best leaders double as your best players? Maybe not one for one, but aren't the best teams typically where the best leader on the team is one of, if not the best player on the team? Because like Al Horford's, I think, a good leader, but he's not going to be the best player on the Celtics. Like that's a part of the equation.
I think people try to make the best player the leader, but
right,
that's not always the case. Right now, to me, Al Horford is a better leader. Look at the teams he's been on.
Sure.
All right? He's been in championship contention, won championships in college. The way they played, the reason they played last year had a lot to do with him.
Yep.
And he didn't have to get credit, because a lot of times when you're doing stuff like this and you're saying stuff like this, the reason why you're putting it out there is so if it turns around, you get credit for it. LeBron did a lot of things behind the scenes in Cleveland he didn't want to get credit for, because that's what leaders do. So for me, I still need to see a lot more in Kyrie Irving. And what if Kyrie's not a Celtic long term? What kind of leadership is that showing? Because if the team feels like he's not fully committed, maybe these young guys see through all that already.
Certainly a great first step if he is going to do something to A, do it, and B, talk about it. But just a quick question about the team itself before we move on. It seems like Kyrie's biggest issue with the team is experience. He talks about that. Is experience the one thing that you think is holding this team back?
No.
When you didn't think this team would be, is it because of experience?
No. It's not because of experience. It's because I don't think the pieces all fit together exactly right. I think that you've got a more talented unit than last year. But last year, they were up 3-2 in the Eastern Conference Finals. Does anyone right now, do we really think they're going to be in that same position again this year? Do we think this team is better positioned than last year? Now, part of my skepticism was I didn't think they were getting back two All-Stars because I didn't know who Gordon Hayward was going to be. That's been proven out to be true. I hope Gordon Hayward gets it back at some point, but it doesn't look like that will be this right. year. The other part of it was Jason Tatum got the star treatment and earned it with his play. It is hard for a guy drafted as high as he was, who went to Duke, who all of a sudden is a rookie, is awesome in big moments, to now take not only a secondary role, a third or fourth role on the team. How it, not a lot of guys are equipped for that. So for all those reasons, and because I didn't know if Kyrie had never been the best player on a good team ever, well, since high school. And even his high school teams actually weren't that good because he went to some very small high school. He went to small I think it was private school in Jersey. And so he didn't have the experience for it. And I just love the talent of some of the other teams. But this is, he had to do this at least privately. Publicly, I'm glad he did it because I don't think it was looking for credit. Maybe it was partially, but I think it's almost a public mea culpa. He very publicly undercut LeBron with that interview with Stephen A. I think now this is a man, I got this part wrong.
I'm wait and see.
Okay.
I'm gonna wait and see. I've seen too many signs of other things to be. The biggest problem is not necessarily the leadership. The biggest problem in Boston is style. Brad Stevens' style does not match their best player, the most talented player that they have. They do not match. Brad Stevens is motion, is get the ball, let everyone touch it, and no one is really the point guard in Brad Stevens' offense. We talk about his defense. We know they're great defensively. But offensively, Kyrie Irving and the way he wants to play does not fit the style that Brad Stevens coaches. That's the biggest problem in Boston. It's not leadership.
All right. Leave it there. Take a break. Coming up, is James Harden's incredible season being wasted? That's next on First Things First. He's a pretty good leader.
I think about 2022, Nick Wright's going to call me. Hey, see, I'm sorry, man. I was such a jerk. I thought I knew. But you're right. Kyrie Irving, I'm working with one. Well.